Hi there, this is Sjoerd de Vries from Mr. You Perform on YouTube. In a short video tutorial, I'll show you two options to use the review process or a review process with You Perform. The first step is to use the tools that Ansely provides, and the second one is using a second tool we bought a subscription for, and it's called ReviewMyElearning.com. So the obvious choice is first look in the review options in YouPerform. To do this, you have to create an annotation set. So click on the View menu to display annotations, then create an annotation set. And that's it. Now check in your content and distribute your topic amongst You perform authors or start a review process on the You perform server. Basically, people will then download the content, open it up, start reviewing it. So they're typing in comments in here, and maybe they also have to publish content or preview the content itself first. And that's the actually the issue I'll have with this process. It's nice for You perform authors. However, if you do not want to review your content by a YouPerform author, but by a SME who actually needs to see the end content, so the published content, so to speak, then this is not really suitable. Therefore, we use another tool, which is called Review My E-Learning. So in this case, I search for it, www.reviewmyelearning.com, and that tool is specifically created to support Articulate Storyline Presenter, Adobe Captivate Presenter, Lectora, iSpring. And if you want to know what's more supported or what about the pricing, just look them up. I do not have any relation with the Review My E-Learning site. We just have a subscription to their tools. At least I contacted them, and we use it mainly for Storyline. However, they recently created some support for me to also be able to use it with YouPerform, and I will show you that. So first of all, the Review My E-Learning tool looks like this if you look at it from a course owner's perspective. So you have a complete dashboard. If this is actually the dashboard for one course, where you can see the comments done. So in this case, 15 comments were done. You can see the course and the comments also in the learning. So you can start it up here and start to use browsing the e-learning course. As you can see here at the right screen, you will see then the comments if they are created in the current. So, for example, here I can start training. As you can see here, there is a comment created. So, both for providing content as for reviewing the comments back. You actually can just browse through the e-learning or just see the list view or go directly to the specific part from the list, discuss with the reviewers their point, and this is what is actually really great.
For
I
the
know
purpose of this
that
demonstration.
at least Storyline started to have a kind of review process with Storyline 360, but it's really not as comprehensive and advanced as this tool. So even for Storyline, I would at the moment also prefer this tool. However, the big news, because we're recording this for Mr. YouPerform, is you can also use this for courses created with YouPerform. If I add this course, then you will see here the approved tools. So I'll browse through an approved tool. However, it will also work for YouPerform. So this is my publication folder. So here, this is the website, the SCORM file, and the SIPT SCORM file is also published with it. So that's what you need, a zip scom file. Then you create the course. And while the course is being created, you can see the dashboard with all the courses. If you have a lot of courses, you probably want to sort things by or filter things by labels or owners. I'll have to wait before the course is created. So that's done now. And I can view it directly. So first of all, I'll add developers. So let's put in my work account in here. I don't want to send an email to the developers at this stage. And I can also add a reviewer. I also can send an email to the reviewers. Let's say, hi, Sjoerd, let's review this one. But for now, for the demo, I will just add them. It's also possible to get links. As you can see, course is ready, so there is workflow behind it. It will communicate with the owners. I can get links here as well. So for the demo, I will get this link, which is usually mailed to people. Something that's important to set up correctly, I can, for example, require login or not. So in this case, I will set the link open to anyone with link, and I can even have a public invite where you just have one link, send it to a big group of people and just ask them to review the content. I can add labels to make it easier to find the content back if you have a lot of content to re-reviewed. But that's basically it, because it's just starting now. So let's assume I am the reviewer. So I did receive the link. And when the reviewer views this the first time, he can take a short tour where everything is explained. And for the demo, it's nice to see. Here you have the options to comment on your course. You can just browse through it, have a title, have a comment, and select an option so you can later on see if it's all graphics or audio or general comments. And you can even download, or you can even discuss with it other comments around it, so you can use that as well. And at the end, you just have to exit. When you're done, you can start your review. And in this case, for YouPerform, it's a little bit more complicated, because YouPerform actually works with a lot of pop-ups where you have a lot of modes. So for the review process, I published it to one mode, the Let Me Try, which we called interactive mode. And the thing is that this one pops up in a new window. So that's different from the other applications like Storyline and Captivate. So in this case, if I want to comment on this, so for example, this one topic is not only for YouPerform authors, but also for SMEs. Please also add the role SME. And this is a text or content, actually. So I can save this one. And though I cannot proceed here, it's still as pop-up is open, so I can just click
type on type review e-learning through in text box.
So I'll have to type in review e-learning,
press return,
and then press return,
click link label.
So let's assume that there is an option on this screen which is not correct. I can go back, and as you can see here now, it's automatically step 4. Okay, so this is a great tool. Now the caveat, which you have to be aware of, that if you go back and you perform with the steps, for example,
type
I
review
click
e-learning
on,
in text box
on this one, which I'm now on step 2 of 5. As you can see, it's still on step 4. So if you want currently use this with you perform, you can also do it this way, of course, but it's just a workaround. And that's what I mean with it. It's not fully supported, but it's very, very useful to use it together with the Review My E-Learning tool. If I exit this one, I mark it complete. So as a reviewer marked it complete, it is notified to the course owner that it's marked complete, so he can also take a look. And if I update my dashboard as a course owner, I can see all the comments made. The difference between Storyline is that you cannot directly go to your course, unfortunately. However, your performance is very simple. You have just the steps here. The only thing is if people go back and commented on that, it might be useful to just add steps here as well. That's the only disadvantage I see for the moment. Maybe it will be solved in the future. We never know. That's depending on the number of customers that use the Review My E-Learning site in combination with YouPerform. I think it's worth to mention, and we actually love it. Thanks for watching my demo tutorial.